Hi friends, welcome to the channel Unshackling Sudoku and Puzzles. Myself Ashish, and today I'll be covering a Sudoku variant called X-Anti Windoku. This Sudoku is going to be featured in the upcoming contest on Logic Masters India called the Lockdown Contest. The author of the contest is R. Kumaresan, and he has authored many such contests in the past on LMI. He has even authored Sudoku Mahabharata rounds also. So, and he has even authored Asian Sudoku Championship recently in Hyderabad. And I would really suggest you to check out the contest page. There are quite a good number of Sudoku variants in it, and I feel it would be one of the best contests on LMI. So, coming on to the Sudoku, according to the rules, we have to place digits 1 to 9 in each row, each column, and each 3x3 box without repetition. There are some window like shapes in the Sudoku, the four window shaped Sudoku, which are called Windokus. And in these shapes, there will be exactly four digits which will be appearing twice, and one digit that will be appearing once, right? So there are nine digits in this window shape, nine cells forming a window shape, and those nine cells will have to be four digits appearing twice, and one digit that will be appearing once. And the one digit that will be appearing once will be appearing in all these four windows once, right? So that is called an X, right? So there will be four digits that is appearing twice in each window, which gives you eight digits exactly. And one digit in each window ku will be appearing once, and that is called the X. So X is same for all the four window kus, right? So that is the rule. So coming on to the Sudoku, before solving the Sudoku, I would like to say you some tips that will help you to solve this kind of genre very fast, this kind of variant very fast. So if you see, according to the rule, there are some things or there are some tricks that can be revealed, and the tricks are, I'll just mark it here. If you see these 9 digits, these 9 digits will have to be 1 to 9 in any order. So this logic is also applied in a Windoku Sudoku. Yeah? If you have solved a Windoku Sudoku earlier, then you'd see this trick. We also have a video on a Windoku Sudoku in our channel. You can just check out that Sudoku. I'll give the link in the description for the Sudoku, as well as the link for the contest page by Kumaresan sir, and the link of the online interface of the Sudoku that we'll be solving today. So do check out the Windoku Sudoku. You will understand the tricks in that Sudoku easily. So the same trick also applies here. These nine digits will be have to be 1 to 9 in any order. Same way, these 9 digits will have to be 1 to 9 in any order. These 9 digits will have to be 1 to 9 in any order. And these 9 digits also will have to be 1 to 9 in any order. This is one of the trick that helps us to solve the X anti Windoku very faster. One of the other trick is, these 9 digits, if you see, the remaining white cells will also have to be 1 to 9 in any order, right? So you don't know the order, but these also will have to be 1 to 9, right? This is the second trick. The third trick is, whatever four digits you have here, which appears twice in this window ku, will be the same four digits that appear twice in this window ku, the diagonal window ku. This is also one of the good tricks here. So if you get to know that there are two fours appearing, then you can, there is one more four here appearing, then you know that there are two fours appearing here. Then you can make sure that the same two fours also will be appearing here in this window ku. This is one of the third trick to solve the Sudoku, right? So the same way, whatever four digits that are appearing twice in this window ku will also appear those four digits twice in this window ku as well, the diagonal window ku's, right? So that is the third trick for this X anti window ku. The fourth and the last trick I would say is, if at all you come across a instance that you have a digit, for example you have a 5 here in this window ku, and by some chance after progressing some of the numbers, you come across a 5 on this window ku, right? You already have a 5 on this Vindoku. And if you come across the same digit in the orthogonal adjacent Vindokus, not this diagonal one, but looking for this Vindoku, the orthogonal adjacent are these two Vindokus, either this one or this one. So if you have a 5 on this Vindoku, and by some means after solving a few digits, you come across another 5 on the another adjacent Vindoku, then you can make sure that that digit is the X digit for the grid, right? There is an X digit called X, this Sudoku is X anti Vindoku, right? And there is a digit X that will be appearing once in all the 4 Vindokus, right? So by some chance, if you get to know that the 2 digits are the same, there are 2 same digits on a different Vindoku, different adjacent Vindokus, then that digit will have to be X for sure, right? You cannot have 2 5s here and 2 5s here, right? Not at all possible. So by some means, if you come across a Sudoku, come across this instance that you have a 5 here and you get a 5 here somewhere in this Vindoku, then that 5 have to be the X number, right? So that is the 4th trick, I would say. So these are the things. And one more thing is, the 4 digits that are appearing twice in this Vindoku will never be the those 4 digits that will be appearing twice in this Vindoku, adjacent Vindoku, right? So you will have 4 digits appearing in the three rows, which is not possible, of course. By classic Sudoku rules, it is never possible. So whenever you have those 4 digits appearing twice in this Vindoku, those 4 digits will never appear twice in this or this Vindoku, right? So that is the trick. And those 4 digits will not also be the X number. That X will not be these 4 digits. So these are the tricks that will help you to solve a X anti Vindoku. And coming on to the Sudoku, let's see if we can solve this Sudoku. This Sudoku was constructed by me, and it has some very narrow logics in it. There are quite few of 2 or 3 narrow logics, and those logics will surely help you to solve this Sudoku and any of the X anti Vindoku Sudoku, right? So coming on to the Sudoku, let us mark some numbers by the classic rules, right? The 5 has to come here, if you see, and one. If you see the yellow cells, it is nothing but an extra region Sudoku with 1 to 9 in any order, right? So if you see, where can 1 come in that Sudoku, in that region, I mean to say. 1 cannot be in one of these 3 cells, 1 cannot be in one of these 3 cells, so 1 has to be in one of these 2 cells, right? Same way, where can 6 come in this region? A 6 cannot come here as well, so a 6 has to be in one of these 2 cells, right? Superb. So you have a 6 here, which means you will have a 1 here, a 6 here. We got a 1-6 pair here, and that has helped us to solve these 2 digits. So if you see, there are exactly 5 digits written in this yellow region. 4 digits are remaining, which are 2, 3, 5 and 8, right? So we can just write 2, 3, 8 here. 2, 3, 5, 8. 2, 3, 8 and 2, 3, 5, 8, right? Exactly. So we get anything else here now? If you see 9, where can 9 come on the red region? 9 cannot be in these 2 cells, neither these 2 cells. So 9 has to be in one of these 2 cells. But you already have a 9 here, which means 9 has to be here, right? And by classic rules, 9 and 9, a 9 has to be here. And a 9 and a 9 here will get you a 9 in one of these 2 cells, right? So I can just mark that here. If you see, where can 4 come in this column? A very good deduction here is, if because of the 4 here and a 4 here, a 4 has to be in one of these 3 cells in this column, which means all the other possibilities of the 4 from this box is eliminated, right? And okay, so Where can 9 come in this box? In three, in this third box, 9 cannot be here. 9 cannot be in these two cells. So because of the 9 here, a 9 has to be here, right? And then after that, 9 has to be in one of these two cells. Sorry. 9 has to be in one of these two cells by classic means. Okay, and now if you see the blue region, where can 9 come in the blue region? A 9 has to be on the blue region. A 9 cannot be here. A 9 cannot be here because of these two 9s, and a 9 has to be in one of these two cells, and because of the 9 here, a 9 has to be here, right? Great one. So then a 9 has to be in one of these two cells in this box, right? So anything else we get here? 6 9 7 1. Okay, I don't think it's anything much here. So let us mark the remaining three digits here. If you see, 358 are the remaining three digits, and let us mark that 358 358, and a 5 is here, so it has to be 3 and 8, right? And okay, 962. So if you see the blue region again, where can 2 be on the blue region? A 2 cannot be in these two cells. Because of the 2 here, you cannot have 2 in these two cells as well as. And you have only one cell remaining for the 2, which means that has to be a 2, right? And where can 4 be in this column now? Ninth column. A 4 cannot be here. A 4 cannot be here. So a 4 has to be here, right? So the three remaining digits are 3, 8 and 7 in any order. So we are not sure of that. We'll just mark 3, 8 and 7. 3, 7 and 8, I would say. And okay, a 2 has to be in one of these two cells, right? So we'll just mark that in this box. A 2 has to be in one of these two cells. And okay, so if you see, there cannot be a 2 appearance of 9 on this box, right? You cannot place 2 9s in this box anyhow. You have a 9 here, so all these 4 cells are eliminated. You have a 9 here, all these 3 cells are eliminated. You have a 9 here, you eliminate 9 from here. So you have only one place for the 9. And if you see here, this is very narrow logic here. If I place a 9 here, for example, if I place a 9 here, then we are sure that the x is 9, right? Because there cannot be a second appearance of the 9, which means 9 is only one time appearing in this window code, and then that means that has to be the x number, right? So if you place this 9 here, where can you place the 4? Now you know that if 9 is appearing once in this box, it means that 4 has to appear twice in this box, because every other digit will have to appear twice. Can you place the second 4 in this box now? No possible way at all, because all the five boxes are eliminated, and all these two boxes are also eliminated because of this 4, and because of the 4 being in one of these three cells, you eliminate a 4 from here as well. It means that 4 will also appear once in this box if you have a 9 here. What a narrow logic this is, which means that a 9 cannot appear here, and a 9 has to be here, right? Which means a 9 has to be here in this box, right? This is one of the narrow logic that is very difficult to see, I would say. And okay, let us mark the pencil marks here. What are the digits here? 3 2 8 7, right? 2 3 8 7 remaining. And okay, a 2 has to be here in this box, so small miss possibility. A 2 has to be here in this box, which means this digit have to be 3 7 and 8, right? Exactly. And दिस वुड बी 2694135 87. वाई एम आई राइटिंग दिस नंबर इज बिकॉज यू विल फाइंड अ वेरी नैरो लॉजिक हियर. आई वुड देर इज वन ऑफ ट्रिक आई वुड से नॉ नैरो लॉजिक एज वेल एज अ ट्रिक दैट यू शुड सी इन अ एक्स एंटी विंडो को राइट. एंड नाउ एज आई ऑलरेडी सेड दैट यू हैव टू हैव दो सेम फोर डिजिट्स दैट आर अपियरिंग आई वुड से सेम फाइव डिजिट्स राइट. The same the five digits that are appearing in this window will have to be the same five digits appearing in the same number of digits used. I mean to say, if you have four digits used twice, so those same four digits will have to be used here twice, and the X which is placed here will have to be placed here as well. One of a small suggestion or I would give you while solving an X ante window code is, you know that the four digits will have to be appearing twice in a window code. So a small warning I would give you is, never assume to be the four digits appearing twice will be these four digits, right? No way it is possible in all of the anti window code Sudoku, right? Anti X anti window code. So you just might assume that the four digits that will have to be appearing twice in a X anti window code will have to be these four digits in the box, right? Not at all possible. I would not say it is not at all possible. I would say it is not possible for all the grids, because what happens is, you can have an X number that will be appearing here, and you might have a digit that will be appearing twice, one here and here. So it is not necessary to have that for those four numbers in this box alone, right? You can have the X number here somewhere, and you can have a digit here that will be appearing twice outside this box, right? You can have those two digits here. So that is one of the most important note I would like to give you. Never assume those four digits that are appearing twice will have to be these four digits, because then you will might break the Sudoku, right? And let's see if that thing is helping here, that thing is applicable in this Sudoku or not, right? And if you see, you have an 8 here, which means 8 will have to be appear here. We are not sure once or twice. The 8 can be the X number as well as the number that will be appearing twice. We are not sure of it, but we are sure that one of the 8 will have to be appear in this box, right? Now, one of the logic I would say here is, can a 5 appear here? So what happens if you have a 5 here? Let us assume you have a 5 here, which means 5 has appeared twice, and you cannot have a 5 here. 5 will be appearing thrice then. Right, then can you have a 5 here now? Which means that you have 3 5s already in those 3 columns, right? And you won't have the 5 in the yellow region as at all. Or the other trick I said you already is, the other way to see this logic is, when you have 2 digits appearing on a window code, you cannot have that same digit appearing in the adjacent window codes, right? So what happens here is, if I have a 5 here, a 5 was in one of these two cells, and you cannot have a third same digit in the window code, that means a 5 will have to appear here in the next adjacent window code, which means it is contradicting the trick, right? The trick which I said you is, when you have two same digits on a window code, that same digit will not appear on the adjacent window codes at all, which means that you cannot have a 5 here, right? It is nowhere possible that you can have a 5 here, which means the remaining digits are 1, 3, 4 and 8, right? So these are the digits. Not 4, sorry. 1, 3, 7 and 8. Now if you see the logic here, there is a very narrow logic, very tough logic that is applied in this Sudoku. You know that 9, 8, 2 and 5 are already used in this four in these two window codes, right? Because the digits will have to be same. So it means 2 has to be used here and 5 also have to be used here, and 8 will have to be used here. Which means 9, 2, 5, 8 are already used in this window code. We don't know the fifth digit, right? And the fifth digit will have to be in one of these two cells, because let us assume you have 8 already in one of these two cells, then the fifth digit will have to be either of 1, 3 and 7, right? There are exactly two digits, two possibilities of this cell, 1, 3, 7 and 8. right? And 137 and 8, out of 137 and 8, 8 is already used as the fourth digit. So one of the fifth digit will have to be 1, 3 or 7, right? Which means that all the other possibilities of the other digits can be eliminated from this box. One of the very good trick, I would say, in an ex-ante window go. Whenever you have such pairs, not even pairs, such possibility marked, right? In which, in a way that you already fulfill the 5 digits, then all the other possibilities of the other digits can be eliminated from this box. And the other possibilities are 4 and 6, right? So you already know that 9 to 5 and 8 are used, and one of the 1, 3 and 7 will be used, right? Which means that neither of 4 and 6 will be used in this window coup, which means that the 4 can be eliminated from here, and 6 also can be eliminated from one of these two cells, both of these cells, which means a 6 has to be in one of these two cells, right? Which means that a 4 has to be here in this cell, and because of the 6 here and a 6 here, 6 and a 6 here, a 6 has to be in this cell, right? And a 4 has to be in this cell because of the classic rules. A 4 here will eliminate this cell, a 4 will eliminate these two as well, so a 4 will be in this cell, and a 4 will have to be in this cell, right? Because the 2 4s here and a 4 here, you eliminate, you get a 4 here and you eliminate a 4 from here. So that was the very good logic here. And if you see, because of the 6 1 and 6 1, both 1 and 6 will have to be in these 3 cells. So 6 has to be in one of these two cells and 1 has to be in one of these two cells, right? And 7 has to be in one of these two cells. So you got a 2 7 pair, which means the two digits are 5 and 3, right? 3 and 5. And these two digits have to be 1 and 6 because of the remaining digits in that row. And 1 has to be here itself. So this has to be 1. And this has to be 6, which gets you a 6 here. So if you see, this narrow logic has given us many digits here. And because of the 4 being here, if you see, and we know that 1 to 9 has to be in one of these brown cells in any order, and you already have a 4 here, which means a 4 cannot be here, and a 4 has to be here, which means a 4 has to be here, right? And because of the 7 here, you can eliminate 7 from the red cell again, which means this has to be 2 and this has to be 7. And because of the 2, we can eliminate 2 from these two cells. This has to be a 3 8 and this has to be 3 5 8. Right? And so the remaining 3 digits are 3 5 8 in any order in these red cells, right? So we can write that here 3 5 8 and 3 5 8. Which means that if you see now, we have found a 358 triplet here, which means this has to be a 7. And because of the 7 here, you get a 7 here in this box 3 and you get a 38 pair. Excellent, excellent logic, I would say here. And so the remaining digit in this brown cell is 358, right? Because of the 1 to 9 in any order of these brown cells, all the other digits are filled, which means this has to be 358, right? A 1 cannot be here, and already a 1 is eliminated, right? So okay, so if you see, a 5 is already here, which means it has to be a 3 here in the blue regions, and the other two digits are 1 and 8 in any order, 1 and 8, right? So we can write 1 and 8 in any order here, and this has to be a 5 now, right? And the other three digits here in this column is 1, 3 and 8, right? So we can write those here, 1, 3 and 8. We haven't found the 4 digits in any box and the X also, but I think so, after finding so many digits, we'll be able to find it out. And we have already found the 7 digits here, if you see. 5 digits, I mean to say. 8, 5, 9, 7 and 2, right? So 1 and 3 will not be appearing here, which means it has to be 7 and 8, right? 1 and 3 are out of the possibilities now, because you already have 5 digits, 8, 5, 7, 9 and 2. And one of that digit will appear once and all the other digits will appear twice, right? Which means because of the 7, we get an 8 here. And because of the 8, we eliminate 8 from here, here and here as well, right? and the other three digits are 1, 3 and 5, right? So we can mark that here. 1, 3 and 5. 3 and 5 cannot be here because the 3, 5, 8 triplet is here, which means it has to be 1, right? So we can eliminate 1 from here as well and write 3, 5 possibility here. So the other two digits remaining here are 2 and 7, right? 3, 5, 8, 1, 4, 6, 9, which means 2 and 7. 2 has to be here. 7 has to be here. And because of the 2, now the remaining digits are 1, 3 and 8, right? And because of the 8, we get a 1, 3 here. And a 3, 8 here. Right? Okay. And do we get anything from the green cells now? Because we haven't filled the green cells at all. I think so. You can easily write the 7 here, either by seeing the green cells or by classic rules, the 7 has to be here, right? And which means we can eliminate this 3 from this 3, 5, 8, this possibility. It has to be 5, 8, and this has to be 1, 8, right? 5 is already here, so it has to be 1, 8. And because of the 1, 8 pair, we get a 5 here, a 3 here, and an 8 here, which gives you a 3 here. And because of the 3, we can eliminate 3 from both of these cells and it has to be 5 and 8 possibility, right? And because of the 5, we can directly write a 3 here and a 5 here, which means it has remaining is 1 8 pair in these two cells, and this digit will have to be 1 2 3 4 5 6, right? It has to be 6. And because of the 1 8 here, you get a 7 here, right? And 7 is appearing twice, which is already seen here. And we already have eliminated 1 and 3. So we can eliminate 1 and 3 from here as well. And it has to be 8, right? The 5 digits are 8, 5, 2, 9 and 7, right? 8 has appeared twice, 7 has appeared twice, 9 has appeared twice. So one of 2 and 5 will appear twice, right? And we are not sure which one. So one of the 2 or 5 will have to be the X. And that will appear here as well. And here as well, right? So one of the 2 and 5 will appear here, 2 and 5, and 2 and 5 will appear here. And because of the 8, we can directly write a 1 here, and because of the 1 and 8, we can write a 3 here, and because of the 1, we can write 2, 5, 8, 2, 5, 3 possibility, right? So 3 has to be in one of these two cells. So which means that 3 also will have to appear twice. And 8 is already appearing here, so 8 cannot appear here, it has to be 1. And which means this has to be 8. So 1 is appearing twice, 4 is appearing twice, 6 and 3. So 1, 3, 4, 6 are appearing twice. So in this, the 1 has to be appearing twice here in only, which means this has to be 8. And 3 will also have to appear twice, which means one of these two cells will have to be 3. And you cannot have an 8 here, right? Because 8 is not the X as well as 8 is not appearing in this box. Because 8 is appearing twice in this box. Right? And you cannot have an 8 here, which means it has to be 3. And because of the 3, we get an 8 here, a 5 here, a 3 here. And because of the 5, we get an 8 here. And the 3 have to be appearing twice in this box and that has to be this way. And you have a 2, 5 pair here as well. Right? And you have a 2, 5 here. And which digit will appear twice here? Not sure yet. And because of the 2, 5, you get a 3, 8 here. And 8 is already there. So we have a 3 here, a 1 here. Right? And anything else we are missing here? So 8 has to appear twice, right? Which means 8 has to be here, right? And the X number is now, because of the 2, we get a 5 here, and the X number is the 2 now, right? Which means a 2 will come here, a 2 will come here, a 5 will come here, and a 5 will come here, right? And that gives you a 2 here, right? So now if you see the Sudoku, there are exactly 2 appearing in all the boxes, and all the other digits will be appearing twice in every Windoku box, And if you see here, as I gave you a note, that the four digits will never have to be these four digits that are appearing twice. So if you see, the two eights are appearing here, and the X number is inside this for these four cells, right? So I hope you enjoyed this Sudoku. I hope you learned something from the video, some tricks that will be helpful to solve in the contest. And don't forget to subscribe the channel. That is the most important thing I would say. And don't forget, if you want us to solve any other Sudoku variant or a puzzle genre, and do like and comment if that is the case. Thank you.